At this time, I'm going to ask you to fasten your seatbelts.
Gang! Wavy! Honey, 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 honey. Honey, 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 honey. Honey, 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 honey. Ha! Gang in the spot. Wavy! Say you my nigga, then say that. Don't try to switch sides, nigga, I don't play that. Couple bands on your head, homie, slide to the crib where you stay at. Me and gang go way back. Big bag, I'ma make that. If you take a loss and I lose, nigga, just know gang gon' shave you my nigga, then say that.
Yeah, all the way over there. Yeah, but welcome back, man. We happy to be back. We know it's been a long time.
Yes, sir.
I was like, think of it like a television series. You know, you got season one, you gotta wait, you know what I mean, till next fall.
Yeah. Kinda make people kinda wonder a little bit. You know what I'm saying?
That's the excuse I'm gonna use.
For the ones who are showing love, we appreciate y'all for even remotely reaching out, saying, yeah, you know, like, hey, what's going on? We ain't see y'all on in a minute.
Yeah.
Well, reconstructing.
Definitely a little reconstruction. You know, let's, you know, elephant in the room. Obviously, you see it's just us two right now.
Yeah. That's what I was trying to, like, get.
Now, let's just, you know, let's get the knife. Just cut right in there. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Obviously, you guys don't see MVP. You don't see Shay.
Right.
I mean, you haven't seen none of us in a long time. But going forward, it's just going to be me and Dice. I mean, if they come back, you know, they want to jump on the set, they always welcome. Of course, they family. But to keep this show going while, you know, everyone's working on personal growth and everything, so I'm all for it. But the show has to go on one way or the other, right?
Yep, as it should.
All right, so much love to y'all. You know, see y'all soon when y'all come back.
Right. It's always a home for y'all here. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
That's but no beef, though. There's no beef.
This ain't no static.
Yeah. You get what I'm saying? They're like, yo, what happened to them? No beef.
And now we're not just saying that to say that. It really isn't, like, no static. Yeah. At all. We all kind of have, you know, life shit kind of going on, you feel me? Trying to figure out what's going on. When random shit happens, it's like, what do? Right? You know what I'm saying? We all have moments like that. We don't know how long it's going to last. So, you know what I'm saying? That's where we at with it. But since we've been gone, a lot has been done. A lot has been going on.
Or
businesses, plans. Y'all gonna see a lot of that come to fruition, obviously, through the pod. It's a lot of other extra stuff you're gonna start seeing, more content, more of our views for a lot of different stuff, not just the East.
All right.
But it's still views from the East. I mean, don't forget that shit.
We're gonna switch things up a lot. We're gonna be doing, like, obviously we're gonna be doing what we're doing here with you guys, but then we also gonna do live showing, right?
Cause right,
now
right.
We have the software, we have the technology, so now we kind of get on live. We could do...
we upped it.
Right. Pardon me. You know, it's always that free promo.
You're gonna have to hit the silencio on that. Nah, I did in the midst of your shit. I hit the silencio in the midst of your shit.
It's the wifey, though. Wifey 9 months pregnant, so I gotta pick up all times. My apologies, y'all.
Now, you don't apologize when you got something in the oven. You understand what I'm saying? You gotta make sure, as you know what I mean, as one of the chefs, that everything goes well. You know, so. You gotta make sure Chef 2, well, no, that's Chef 1, you Chef 2, right? We technically Chef 2, Chef 1, we gotta make sure Chef 1 backed up, you know what I'm saying, got the support that's needed, you know? I mean, we was gonna kind of like let you guys know in the midst of the pod in some sense and manner, but since it's here,
right?
You know what I'm saying? Congratulations to the bro.
It was going on, you know, baby number 2 coming.
With 2 rolling in. It's always a beautiful thing, man.
Always.
Always a beautiful damn thing.
When I say coming, what a time to come back. The baby is due like in a week and a half or so. So,
hey.
What a time to come back.
It's right there.
To the pod. So, don't worry. We have our way around that. We're going, you know what I mean? We got content for that. But anyway.
Yeah, y'all might get some content for that. For those who are fathers and the women who do watch, you understand how that process is such a beautiful thing. And for those who are younger who do pay attention, I think you should kind of like, you might enjoy that, Rod. It'll give you an insight on how it is to be a parent and not just talking about, you know, having a baby, not being there every step, the whole step. You know what I'm saying?
From the beginning.
Very important, especially with us as fathers, how society is, or even what they deem to be stereotypes, no longer. You know what I mean? That's not what we're doing here. That's not what we're promoting. And that's not, I hope, that's hopefully who we're speaking to. And if that's who you are, Hopefully we can help you get back on the path.
Absolutely. But yeah, that's coming up. Damn, we've been busy. I mean, we've been gone a long time, y'all, but right. you know, it wasn't just sitting around. Like, we working on shit. Everyone's trying to elevate themselves.
Yes. Right reasons,
Sometimes you just got to move quietly. Sometimes you just got to, you know what I'm saying, like, move in the shadows. And as much as we missed y'all, it's like, we have to at least make it worth it. Like, if we're not doing this, we got to be productive.
Right.
And I think everybody, everybody is being very productive right now. You know, I even want to meet, like, this guy right here, obviously, he's doing music. I'm not sure if y'all, you know, picked up the album yet.
Yeah, please do.
The Saws.
If you haven't. But it's more coming out. And I got a single out right now called Bleed This. So
yeah.
I probably might. Yeah. We're going to probably play that on the next episode or something like that. You guys can hear that. Yeah. It's everywhere, by the way, too.
Absolutely. Everybody is just elevating, trying to work on shit. Prepare for new life.
New
you
brains.
Know what I'm saying? Or just new live prosperity. A different life, bro. Definitely looking for a career switch, bro. I'm not going to lie to you. Your boy is about to really get into the day trading.
Well, this is part of one of the reasons. Not one of the reasons. One of the things that we've been kind of like trying to figure out on our hiatus. How to unplug from the 9-to-5. Right. I know a lot of people want to get to that point, and we're in the midst of it, you know. But what I do want to tell people is it's a lot easier than what you think. That's one. Two is just the steps. Take the step. You're not wrong, or you won't figure anything out until you take the step. Whether or not you have support or not, you self have to believe first to the point that you're a fan. But also the actual producer of what you're doing. Because I feel like a lot of people look for another person to kind of just like lead the situation. For the most part, if it's something that you want to do, you got to do it. People will find you. We're figuring that out. And if you are into it the way you need to be, the right people will find you. And you'll find the right people to help you get to the next step. I do think that, what's the word I'm looking for? Mentor. I think mentors are very, very much needed.
Yes, sir.
I mean, if you don't have one, please do. Even if it's somebody that you don't know, that you're watching, that's kind of like helping you get to a point that you need to, mentally, physically, however, financially. I think it's needed for us as men. Even if you're a young man, even if you're not mentally, we all need a mentor to help us. And something that you want to get into, just not a random person who you deem to be a mentor because they're doing things that you look up to. Because a rapper isn't necessarily a mentor. I would not.
Yeah.
I wouldn't say a rapper as a mentor. Not taken away from a rapper because I am one, but we're constantly learning and absorbing and telling news of what we see. Mm-hmm. We convey that. That's a huge part in being an artist. So it's not always the best thing to look at that person to be a mentor because they're a projection of their environment and their life and the things that they're seeing in a mirror of that. So.
Got a few mentors. Not just one. You can have a few of them.
Yeah. Yeah. It's best to have a few for different.
For different things. Different things. Different purposes.
Different things. Always a great thing.
It's definitely a good thing, man. What's going on? It's been a long time. But what's current? Let's talk about some shit that's going on in the world right now, today.
Okay, so let's start nice. Let's start with something good, right? Polite. So last thing that I've heard of some greatness was Maya Angelou. She's going to be on a quarter, already on a quarter collection. It's a woman's collection that they're coming out with, and I believe she was the first. There's other women on it. I mean, that's coming, but I don't want to talk about that because I want to like kind of shine a light on what is for our community. I don't want to take anything from anybody else, but it's we've because they told us about the Harriet Tubman on a 20.
Yeah.
I mean, and we just kind of ran with that. It never went nowhere. It never seemed to come to light or the day. So this is kind of huge. I'm quite sure some people feel like it should be something more probably because of what her, what she kind of gave back to society within Hold and not just for our people.
Yeah.
I mean, poetry, just your woman, period. So that's huge. But it's just a collectional thing. I don't think it's going to stay there forever. So it's not going to forever be like Harry Tip. I'm not Harry Tip. I'm sorry. My Andrew.
We really want Harry or something, huh?
Right. But I think it's dope. That's fire. What you think about it?
No, I think it's, I mean, you know, I always feel about things like that. You know, better late than never, I guess.
Right.
That's something that should, you know, it's great to see it though. Not to be negative, Nancy. It is fantastic to see it. And I'm happy that in our lifetime, I can take that with me. You get what I'm saying? Because past generations, they'd never fathom this day. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
The way, you know, not perfect yet, but it's obviously a huge difference from what they've seen. So to actually be here and see all of the things that we're seeing, you know, to have kids, to like pass that on, hey, like when you was a kid, this, you know, you also lived through that. So just happy to be here to see a lot of great things happening.
Right.
You know, it wasn't all in vain, I guess.
I agree. It was definitely like shocking. I didn't know. I didn't tell anybody about it. It wasn't like a huge, you know, talk about it. But I think it's dope. Let's see. What else happened, Carmen, that I can align with that? Because we got other things. I just don't want to go there with that.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's start. Keeping it good. The whole COVID thing seems to be kind of like out of hand in a sense.
Again.
But with sports, that's the only thing I meant by good. So the fact that how this COVID is kind of hitting people, how it's hitting people, the new strand, everybody's kind of getting it in a sense. Not everybody, and most likely it seems that way. Hopefully they don't close nothing down. But I was happy to see Kyrie. You know what I mean? I was happy to see him get back on the court because there was a lot of controversy on him choosing to go the path that he chose. And I feel like, you know, they still wound up doing what he wanted anyway, right? Shout out. I think it's I think you should stick to your guns. Anybody, what you believe in and what you just stand on that. Some things aren't necessarily always about money. I think that's fire. That he get to get back on that court though and do what he do. Some fans was heckling him though. I forget what he said. He said something along the lines of, not verbatim, but along the lines of, I gave y'all a ring, y'all still complaining. Because they was talking about we need a ring or something like that. But he in Brooklyn. He was like, and it was Cleveland fans that was like talking shit to him.
Yeah. He was like, yo, I got y'all a ring already.
Yeah, come on, you fucking ungrateful, bro. Like, what are you doing, bro? Like, he said it just like, I'm like, oh shit.
He needs to say that. Who else just came back? Klay Thompson just came back.
That's another one. That's another one. Bro. Yo, I think they may be able to get another ring. And
like
Curry. That? Curry, though. We got to talk about Curry's situation. Since we're here. We might as well. My man hit that record. He passed everyone. He's number one for three-point shooter.
Ray Allen, all of them.
Everybody.
And it's going to be by a huge margin because he's still shooting.
He's still going.
He could be in the league for a while longer. So
I hope so. And I think he's getting in that top five discussion. It's getting to that point that you can't really deny it anymore.
He got some competition, bro. He got Phoenix to go through. He got to go through the Grizzlies. He got to go through a lot. The Bucks.
NBA looking good. I'm not the most, you know, sports guy. But I still keep my head to the ground. You know what I'm saying? It do look kind of crazy. It's a young boy. I don't know his name. I'm not really good at this. So, but I'm going to get better. Trust me. The next time we talk about the sports shit, I'm going to be shooting names. Watch. I'm shooting names out straight from the hip now. Fuck that. Young boy, he went crazy. He blocked the shit. Yo,
you're talking about the Grizzlies.
Homie, that was different.
The point guard.
That was different.
Nah, I don't know his
name. That was different.
Yeah, no, I'm talking about Memphis Grizzly with the dreads.
He went crazy. I was like, what the fuck?
Something rant.
And he's beginning. That's the beginning of this kid's
shit. Yeah, he like 22. Morant. There you go. Morant. That's what I mean. Bro,
it's going to come out. Just like Trae Young. I mean, they this young generation wildin'. They ballin'. They here. They here. But that's why I said Curry's he got to be in the top five. Like, he's getting to the point that he's in the top.
If he gets another ring, they definitely go top five of him. They have to.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't say that just because, you know, shooting a three, I get that. But like, he got a lot of rings under his belt.
Yeah.
And that's before Durant. After Durant, it don't matter.
But a lot of hard work. Well,
not
work,
after though. Durant, but still, like, that's what I'm saying. Like, he put Golden State on the map. Not just him. Golden State, amazing with the the pickups.
Mm-hmm.
Curry, Clay.
Good teamwork, though.
Boy,
they like family now. I think a lot of the teams in the NBA, they family.
No, they're definitely they family, bro. They got a whole squad, but I can't remember the names right now. But y'all know who y'all are. Green, like, there you go.
Yeah, I was about to say.
Still don't get your first name though. Draymond. Nah, let me stop. Draymond. They got a good squad. New York, you know, shout out to y'all just because I'm from the city, so it is what it is. Brooklyn, you already know.
But Brooklyn been doing good. Knicks have their moments where they pull through and then they had their moments. So it's like,
Knicks, it's gonna take. It's gonna I think take they got Knicks a good team. They got a good team, but it's gonna take a little minute because you got to deal with so much right now. There's too many going in right now. The Lakers, you thought the Lakers would have been crazy this year.
Yeah, they've been looking weird.
Cutting Westbrook ass, bro.
He fucking wild out on Rudy Gobert. Yo, he went nuts on that. That dunk was crazy. I ain't gonna lie to you. They gave him a tech. I think they gave him a tech because of that. My man wild on that dunk.
They was like, you gotta go.
LeBron was looking like, yo, that was fine. But yo, bro, no text. Yo, he had that look like, yo, bro, no, like, stats, bro. You gotta like stay it. Like, what are you doing? Like, do it, but don't wild out.
Like dunk the ball, but don't go crazy on him.
Don't go crazy, bro. Man, that shit is funny. Shout out to LeBron too, though, because I mean he been showing up a lot. You know what I'm saying? I've been hearing that through the grapevine too. I've seen a couple drinks, but a lot of people say he's been showing up.
You just gotta give LeBron his dues. Yeah, you just gotta give it to him. Like the hate and all of that, I get it. But like, there can be multiple greats, and he's ODing.
He's one of them.
ODing, not at that age. He's ODing at that age.
I think within the community of even sports community, we really just don't like multiples. People just don't like multiples. They feel like it's confusing to mention 17 people who are great. Just like to kind of keep it short within the discussion of a five, debate that and kind of go on. Because with five, people can debate all night. So if you start bringing 17 and 10 in, it's like people going to lose their shit, and it's never going to be an end to that situation.
Well, it's based off of the rings. Because look, when you hear football quarterback, who's the best quarterback of all time? They're going to keep saying Tom Brady, right? I mean, he did get to the Super Bowl
He's
wild. Yeah,
he's wild. I'm a friend. Yo, this is a good seg because this is where I was going. Yo, boy. Antonio Brown. He was so let's start this from the beginning because a lot of information kind of came in, so it changed up the outlook of the situation. Then he wilded out a little bit again, right? And then kind of trying to patch it up. So, all right, let's take it this way. So, let's take it slow, man. So, basically, first thing, for those probably know, because it's like somewhat old news and shit, but this is our view. Fucker. He, from the way it looked like he had a disagreement with the coach, right? Didn't want to get in the game, complained about his ankle. The coach was basically saying, like, I wasn't really trying to, like, force the kid or nothing like that. It just is a part of what he's supposed to do. He was saying that he's good to go, and everybody said he's good. His ankle's not that bad where he can't play. And he played earlier, I believe. So, he disagreed. And then, like, kind of went off the field, took off his jersey, all that shit. He looked like he was doing jumping jacks through the stadium and then, like, exited. So he looked kind of like he was losing his shit, but calmly losing his shit. He didn't, like, wild out, hit nobody, nothing like that. Yeah. Not aggressive, but it looked crazy. Mm. So everybody, like, we were like, what the fuck is this guy doing? Like, they just got a ring. You know what I mean? This is the second year. Come back, make it happen again. Stay on course. You got Brady on the team. You got the Brock guy. Everybody's rolling. So what the fuck is wrong with you? So this is the outlook, right? Then a couple days down the line, information come out that the coach actually was being a dick. And his ankle was really bad. He was complaining about it from the gate. But they just weren't paying any attention to the situation. So he wasn't wrong. And he went on a couple of interviews and was kind of trying to explain it without explaining it. So not answering it direct, but kind of like getting around the point that like it was my ankle wasn't, you know. Couldn't do it, told him about it, et cetera, et cetera. And the coach was being a dick. He doesn't have really a good relationship with the coach, I believe. He's there because of, you know, Brady or, you know, everybody who, I guess, agrees with Brady that he's a good fit for the team so they can take it to the next level and keep this kind of, you know, this thing going within the Buccaneers and shit. So then after that, my man gets on an interview, Antonio Brown, and somebody was asking him about, like, you know, what's your relationship with Brady? You know, he looked out for you, et cetera, et cetera. And then Antonio Brown's response was, he's not really my friend. Like, he ain't really there. Right?
Yeah,
like,
also,
I'm really there. I'm really there because I'm great. I'm great at what I do. I'm a great, you know what I mean, player. And will, everybody know that. And that's one of the main reasons. I'm a good piece that's needed. So that's why I'm there. Now, a lot of people was conflicted with it because they was like, nah, like he kind of vouched for you, you know, in a sense. But when people were asking, he ain't really like throw you under the dirt.
Yeah.
Even though some people pointed out he didn't champion Antonio Brown.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? But he didn't put you in the dirt. He respectfully answered. But it was one of those, you know, the answer, but it's like you can't get anything out that answer. It's like, but you're Brady, so we don't want to pick at you because you're good at this shit. So you know how to evade and stick your gun. So we'll just take that as it is. So, you know, it was kind of mixed feelings about that. And then kind of Antonio Brown kind of pulled back within the recent and was like, yo, nah, I mean, I spoke with him. I wasn't like, you know what I mean? I didn't mean it in that way.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? He did look out for me in a lot of, and he is my friend. It's just that I was feeling a way about this and this and that and whatever.
Got to retract.
So he was kind of like, it was kind of like looking, he only retract on one thing, but it looked the way how the information is kind of flapping. It can make his character seem floppy.
Yeah,
if you get what I'm saying. I mean, especially if you're not into the like figuring out if he did do all of this stuff, and you're just taking the news as what it is and running it off. Because some people don't really know that he didn't do nothing wrong in terms of that situation when he ran off the field. He was in the right within that situation. Plus, he was also sensitive because he did the extra touchdowns or a certain amount of touchdowns, a certain amount of runs or whatever the case may be. So he's supposed to make, I think it was close to $1 million or whatever.
Yeah.
So that's a lot. That's another confliction. People were basically saying he was blowing that $1 million or whatever from walking off the field the way he did. But now he wasn't in the wrong. And I think he's still up for that money because he did reach those incentives. So
also, you still got to pay him and all of that.
They might. It's not 100 yet. Let's see where it's at. I don't know if the Buccaneers are going to take him back. And we got to see where it's at.
I think they play Green Bay. So I don't know. They you know, they still performing well, but. It's fucked up to see that situation. I mean, I don't know. Some people say they have doctors for that. What show I was watching. But he was basically like, yo, he went through a lot of ankle surgeries.
Yeah.
And basically had to, like, they get shots or whatever. That's crazy that there's a shot that just takes the pain away and you just feel normal for a certain amount of time. Bro, that always makes me cringe. I'm like, yo, what kind of drugs he had taken to play the game? You know what I'm saying? Like.
Also,
what's in that shit?
Football makes so much money. Like, they've been in this world so much. It's kind of like football didn't even, like, it had no years without the whole surgeon and making sure that the players are good and make sure we can get these guys back on the field as quick as possible because this is a money situation. So we got to get this. We got to keep this ball rolling. They have their own doctors, bro. They've been had their own doctors for shit. So I even think that, bro, it's to the point that these motherfuckers are, they're in pockets. You know what I'm saying? Like, they make so
crazy.
Much. You know what I mean? They got shit. Gotta make
salary.
A motherfucker go for a hot little minute. And but when he had home, that nigga been paying for another month and a half.
You know what
I'm saying? But he was able to play for that one motherfucking night.
That Super Bowl.
What are they paying for it? They're going to do all of that, but that nigga might not. You know what I'm saying? The longevity of a football player is the highest of 6 years, bro. So people like Brady are like breaking this idea of, nigga, you still playing? It's not, there's no longevity as a player, as a football player, dude.
But quarterback, like, he has a lot of protection.
Quarterback's a little bit different.
It's a little different because they got a whole lineman to protect them, like other people, you know what I'm saying?
But the rest of them, they get banged the fuck up, bro. So it's like, it's a cycle. Like, once you start 3 years, next team. It's like, if you never really realize, a lot of them, they don't stay past a certain amount of years. You think they did, but when you look at it, it's like, oh shit, this nigga was here just only for 2 years.
Where the Ray Lewis's and all of that is gone now.
That shit is, exactly. But even they were like stretching it because he was that good. Like, he was still pulling shit through. It's like, and he not all the way fucked up. He still kind of look alright. Like, I don't know what's going on behind the scenes, but from what I see, he still
looks okay.
Like, he's
okay.
His mind still looks good. So I'm like, all right. So some people could do it, some people can't. But the longevity for football players and as long as a basketball player or any other
absolutely
like sport,
not.
So it's a whole
absolutely
lot different
not.
How they shuffle players in and out. So that's why for them it's really
Clay just missed like 2 years. You're not doing that in no football. They're going to be like, yo,
bro, you're gone. 2 years, you might not make it, bro. Depending on how, if you didn't show shit, you're gone.
Yeah,
you're gone if you ain't show nothing, bro.
That's crazy.
That is motherfucking crazy. What else do we got on sports? Is there anything else? No. I don't. How are we diving at? Who cares? Who? I'm not even asking that anymore. I have other. I have. We got some other shit. I don't quite know if I want to dive directly there though.
What?
You know what I'm saying? Media video? Yeah, I don't want to dive straight to that. But we can do.
We can text me like crazy. I'm like, yo.
All right, so I basically, in a past podcast, a little while back, there was a certain situation that happened in hip hop. You know what I mean? Shook hip hop. And I'm just like, I want to know what's going on with the situation. It was silent. I don't really hear too many people talking about it, but the Tory Lanez and Megan Thee Stallion situation, right?
Ooh.
Okay.
Here we go.
It's been some time, so I think I can talk about this now. I think we can talk about this now. So there's been a couple of updates. Not being discussed at all too much. Only sides of it. Okay, so they're in court. Come to find out, Tory Lanez is no longer on a gag order like that. I think he still somewhat is. He can't speak about it so much because, I mean, you know, it's actively happening.
Which is crazy.
But some information came out that he didn't have any gun residue on him. Nope. But her friend did.
Her bestie.
Her best friend did. that's a huge thing.
Dude. And do they talk now? Nope.
No, they've been stopped talking after the situation. And they haven't been friends since.
There you go. Okay.
Right. Something I pointed out. Something I definitely pointed out. Some other people pointed it out too, but this is not being discussed. So she basically was saying to the fans or whatever, yo, y'all over here trying to make it seem like something else is going down or something. No, he shot me. I know what happened. So she's doubling down.
Yeah.
This is not a backtrack. This is not a, yo, things, mm-hmm. you know, the court's starting to reveal some things that I didn't really know or people was, nope, she's doubling the fuck down. Mm-hmm. Now, as she's doubling down, is not quite assisting the situation. The reason why is because when I believe the Chelsea chick went and hit the stand, or is going to. I don't really think that's going to end up well for her case. Mm. I mean, for her side of the case, her defense. I mean, or prosecution, because it's Tory in defense. I don't think it's going to work in the best for her. I think that might be really, really bad. And if Tory lawyer even remotely get to asking questions in about certain, I don't think this is going to end. I don't think this is really going to end well for her.
Shanka. I mean, here's the thing, and boy, shit like this is crazy. And I mean, here's the thing. When all of this first came out and all of that, we already was saying this, but like, it was like, yo, what if it's a lot? Like, yes, I get it. This is the news. This is what's coming out. This is the whole situation. Mm-hmm. But the minute we heard, yo, there's a possibility it might not be the case, it was like, yeah, but what if? Like, you can't just dismiss it now and just fully... Until the case is closed. And first of all, what took the case so long to be closed? I understand it's COVID and all that shit going on, but damn. Then the she fact that he was given a gag order from the gate, like he couldn't, he got to throw some previews in his album. Got to throw a little
literally.
Bit. You know what I'm saying? Like, you got to talk to people through the music discreetly. Word to me. So for me, it's like, I never wanted him to be guilty anyway, and I didn't want any of them to lose.
Right, right, right.
It's like, yo, damn, bro, I hope you ain't do it, but it's like, damn, girl, I'm sorry that happened to you. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's one of those in the middle, so it was just like, damn, like, if it's a lie, it's terrible for many reasons, because
there
are women being attacked, black women being attacked and not protected, and you know, there was a whole movement at the time where this was happening.
Yep.
And then you got icons like Taraji and all of them, icon to me, because that's my age era, but you know what I'm saying? Like, people like that come, you know, standing up for you and everything. You better not be wrong.
Boy.
Because all I can remember is in Tory's album when he was like, yo, it's not going to be the same. Like, it's going to cost more. You know what I'm saying? Because everyone basically just, I mean, not everybody,
didn't want to be publicly seen with him, didn't want to do any music with him. But here's the thing that I realized and witnessed. Okay, so in the beginning, once the case like started kind of like bubbling up, before a lot of the information came out, all of a sudden, Tory's, like a lot of people who weren't seen with him were now like seen with Tory. Think about it.
Slotted
in. He was a little bit before the case even kind of like started, like, I mean, court-wise, he was seen with Drake. Yeah. this wasn't a hidden thing. Did you see Drake say, hey, yo, that's not my man's. I'm not. Yeah. No, right? Okay. Did you see anybody who was seen with him back up from anything? Like, oh, nah, you know, the whole situation with, you know, I'm not going to fuck. No.
Yeah.
Like, they would. It seemed like the industry figured it out before it even hit that, nope, this nigga didn't do it. They're not saying anything about it. But it's as if, just pay attention to the movement. How much feature things is she hopping on? This doesn't seem to be the same game anymore.
Yeah.
Really think about it's what I'm saying. It's now they're gonna use the she was in school and wasn't she in school while she had a single and touring? We're not finna play that game, bro. We're not finna do that. Bruh, it's a couple things. And it's like they seem to be just like from her camp, just throwing small achievements out, like to ignore what is right there in people's faces, but that's not being discussed about. Shit is looking.
Do you think it's like building a shield on her end? Like, let me throw out all these accolades and show how valuable I am to this world and the art that I bring in, you know, and that'll shield me from the possible repercussions of, yo, I may have, it wasn't him type situation.
This is the business. What I think it is they need to make their return. You gotta remember, I'm sorry to say it, they really, honestly, really don't care about their fucking clients like that, right? So, you're my artist, you're my, I invested a certain amount of money in you at the beginning of this year. Yeah. Now, with all due respect to you, I gotta make my money back.
Yeah.
Because whether or not we're friends, I can't go broke. I can't lose my stature within this industry because then it's gonna be hard to get it back. Yeah. This is a different game, and this is why, in a sense, it will affect her more than it affect him, because he's in a circumstance where he's self-made. He's been off the label that he was on before that shit even happened.
Yeah.
So he's first that and foremost
shit is costing him a lot.
Let's make it clear what's happening with this guy. This while this was going down, my man dropped 6 projects in a year, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, cool. Mm-hmm. All of them shits was rocking.
Mm-hmm.
All of them was hitting, bro. Every single one of them. My nigga was dropping videos out the ass. Okay, cool. Not only that, my man makes a project.
Yeah.
Makes an NFT for the project.
Yep.
It's NFT'd.
Yep.
This is he's one of the first artists to do that.
And it's for sale. I forgot the platform that it's called, but cool.
My man made, I think, $500K in about maybe a couple of minutes. All right, bro, he don't even have a copy of his own project. Okay, if that doesn't give you a spectrum of how it seems like the world is seeing this compared to how specific people are seeing it. Now, you could be with a crowd of people and all 10 will agree that he's in the wrong. But it don't seem like that's the projection of how the world is seeing this.
Yeah. Maybe at first, in the first hour, it was dark, but then it's like, all right, we're getting more details now. Okay, what's
something's
going on?
Weird.
All right, yo, the way he's singing in these tracks, it can't be. You get what I'm saying? Like this, like he's pleading and he's speaking, but he can't gag order. So it's like, gotta talk you through the music. So, I mean, It's crazy, and it's crazy that you mentioned he is self-made. He's not signed, so you know that shit was caught. That shit's coming out of his pocket. Lawyer fees, all of that. But what you said was key here is the fact that he was able to drop all that music, still be relevant. It's like even if y'all wanted to be mad, y'all couldn't ignore him for too long because people was like, yo, this fucking asshole, but damn, this track is, this guy is. So I noticed that where it's like, yo, this guy's still pulling in like 8 million views in 1 hour type shit.
See what I mean? But and that's the thing that I'm like, all right, this is something's. I know I wasn't like off in what my prediction was gonna be, but I'm like, bro, this is way more than what I was thinking. I was thinking like people probably was gonna get this nigga about a 2-3 year hiatus of not really fucking with. Yeah. It never stopped for him.
It never stopped.
The views never stopped. The plays never stopped. It just didn't stop for him. Mm-hmm. He still kept putting in this work. I'm like, then he kills shit with the NFT shit. I'm like, bro, what he did with the NFT shit, he cracked the game. Like what I mean by that, it's like. He's in the midst of the people, the industry, literally. If you got a label, they are not fucking with you off of this, bro. Yeah. And you make an NFT that busts the whole you sell the whole shit. This shit is, people are reselling this shit. Yeah. Like, it's actively going into some shit where it's like a collector's item off the rip. Yeah. What in the fuck? Who's doing that? With a label, without a label, who's doing that?
Yeah, he's the first.
And already put out 6 projects in a year. You do all that in a year, nigga?
Yeah.
Nah, bro.
Yeah, time.
Best comeback. I don't think
dog, I don't think I've ever seen that type of resilience, bro.
Yeah.
I've never seen that type of fucking resilience, bro.
Under all that pressure.
He's ridiculous, bro. I give that man his motherfucking flowers.
The accusations and all, that's a lot of pressure, bro. Wild, it's not even bro. And you're not a normal citizen like you and me. So we could be going through the same shit the world not gonna know about it. We could navigate and be all right. Yeah. You, the whole world knows. So the whole, like, you have all that, like, damn, the world views me in this way. Like, that shit could break somebody. You get what I'm saying? Like, I could break your spirit and have you just be like, yo, I give up. Or more focused on the case and paying them than it is. But to sit there and make more music, make more art, stay active. He's on social media. Yes, people wasn't really fucking with him like that. So you didn't see him with that many celebrities. But just his whole energy was just like, all right, bro. Like,
work. I'm giving y'all this work. Okay, yeah, what you talking about?
Yeah.
You getting this work.
I don't know.
And the thing is, people didn't even know. Some people may have not known who he was because Megan was considered bigger than him.
Yeah.
Off of just the accusation, he was being looked
at. But that's crazy, though. We only knew he existed, though.
For shooting her now. And see where I'm going with it?
Yeah.
Even going, having that stick to you, so it's like, even new business is fuck. You fucked up even with new business, bro.
Yeah. They're like, you shooting women out here? Nah, it can't go down like that.
See what I'm saying? And you know, bro, the whole women's movement is different. Level
yeah.
at this point, like dude, you can't do shit. Oh, it's over for you. So, I don't, bro. Yo, that nigga, he's the fucking man. Tory is the man, bro. I get that nigga his shit. He showed and proved, bro, for a hot minute. Even battling with Drake, my nigga career been a little like he. It's been at like a point at like you're never gonna make it from the gate. Like, bro, why are you even doing? What are you doing, bro? You're nobody, and this motherfucker just outlasting all of it. That shit's kind of crazy, bro, when you think about it.
Nah, he going crazy. I mean,
that nigga's wild.
I mean, we knew Tory Lanez before Megan. Like, that's dumb. You know what I'm saying? Niggas that be like, yo, who is that? That's OD. He's been putting in that work
for
a minute.
That's for, I guess that's for our culture. But when it comes to, like, she, like, big, bro. People don't even know who, some people who might not even know who he is.
Yeah,
just knew Megan. Of him because of he was dating her.
Megan.
Okay, now. Off that, because I don't want to just keep repeating ourselves on that shit. That's kind of like I don't want to kick a dead horse. But moving from that, now, she had a boyfriend that she was talking to, a dude named Party, musician.
What? Wait, they're not
together? Party Next Door,
bro. You said Party Next Door.
Party Next Door.
Partisan?
Yeah, there we go. All right, so, yo, bro. This is recent. Like, so this is like new news type shit. Bro, she took down pictures or something like that. Or didn't put a picture up of him for his birthday, right?
Mm.
So, like, internet went, like, nuts. Nah, something's up. He didn't be seen with her. I didn't say anything about her for a little minute. It's like, something's going on. Like, they're not, they can't, it's no way that they fucking with each other, right? I find that to be funny. Why? Because a couple of months before that, there was, like, about three people who, like, worked with her. And these are people of, like, fashion. These are people of, like, image consultants. And, like, they worked with her, right? Mm-hmm. And then, like, after that little situation that they worked with, whatever they did, it was like, we're just gonna, you know, part ways or whatever the case may be. And, like, it's as if these motherfuckers don't want to fuck with her. Then, something of what the boyfriend was saying is, like, the reason why we're not together is because she's an angry drunk. I think he put something out saying that she's an angry drunk.
Who?
Megan. Now, here's what's so funny.
The new one.
Yeah. All right, now, this was so funny. Now,
but then
Tory spoke about this, though.
Yeah, then I was going to say, then I heard that.
She spoke about this. Not only that, her friends, before the whole shooting her shit happened, was like, after her mom's passed, she became an angry drunk, where she get drunk and start assaulting people around her. Like, may not be physically, but verbally. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's like the people didn't want to fuck with her no more. And one of the key people in that situation was the friend.
Mm.
You see kind of how it all kind of seems to be, like, tying in? It's like, this shit's crazy, bro. I'm like, nigga, I ain't no motherfucking detective. This is just the information that's being placed out. And I'm like, yeah, something's going on. And it looked like she's not getting it. Like, yo, you need to slow down. You need therapy. You probably, she lost her grandmother, her mother. You know, that's a lot. I think in 1 year or 1 year after another. I'm not 100% sure. But that's a lot. So I don't want to, like, necessarily blame her. But I know there's a lot that she's going through, stardom. Doing all this, it's not easy to even remotely mourn when you're in the midst of a rise. So I can't blame her for it, but at the same time, I think she needs to slow down and really, like, peep what's going on, check herself, kind of, you know, clear who she is, and just, like, figure it out before it gets too bad.
because I don't want to see her underneath the dirt because of the situation. Just like I didn't want to see Tori whole fucking career destroyed over, you know what I'm saying?
That's a career ender. But if that's a career ender, then would it be one for her though?
But the way how it works within the industry, not industry, the industry typically
would get rid of females. A label did just sell, though.
They would get, see where I'm going with it. But look at the small things that's happening behind. Like, it's like things around her seem to not want to stay sustained.
Yeah.
It's like falling apart in the midst of all of this shit.
Let me get my 300 mil. I'm out of here.
Bruh, I don't know, man. This is really not looking good. And the only people who it seems like she really has, who hasn't quite left her yet, is Roc Nation.
A lot of people haven't left her. No, she has a great support system. I'm not even saying she don't deserve it, but I hope she's worthy of it. Because, boy, you don't want, because that could have ended his career. There's a lot of people that go to jail for murder that didn't commit the murder.
Mm-hmm.
And then they come out years later, old, and you know what I'm saying? Oh, you know, exonerated because they didn't do it. So even if it would have came out, this shit could have ended his career. Like I'm saying, he could have just destroyed him. Years later, come out, oh, it was bullshit. It's too late. He already... So the resilience to him again, but...
Crazy.
Meg, you can't let these people down, bro. If you lied, you better come clean yourself. I'm just saying. I'm just saying. You got your platform. I would just... Because, bro, it's like... I mean, again, for me, it's that situation where it's like, damn, I hope he ain't do that. But damn, I hope she's not lying. Like, it's like, yo, I enjoyed the both of them, but it's like, damn, someone got to go down. And if you put his career on the line, his livelihood, his sanity, his freedom, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's your credibility. That's worse than having terrible credit. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're going to be associated with so much. You're going to lose so much. You're an entertainer and all of this. No business going to want to fuck with you.
Kills the brand. His was funny, though. Not funny, but I'm interested to see. Is Kylie going to hit the stand?
Never.
Well, it's at your house, not too far down a block. Let us know what took place before. She might have to hit that. Yo, her mom's is going over and above to make sure that girl does not touch that motherfucking stand. The reason why, because if she touched the stand, she's going to have to make a decision of who career she's going to end.
Right.
I'm sorry to say it that way, but that's really going to be the woo. What's, well, I mean, Megan, if she even remotely says she looked angry, yo. The whole black community coming after that motherfucking chick. You trying to say black women are just aggressive? They are going to fire the fuck off. It doesn't matter that she possibly is lying. No. What's going to happen is we got to make it about something else. We got to change that.
Yeah.
This white bitch over here trying to sit here and say that black woman is angry. It's like, maybe she actually was drunk and acting aggressive because it showed on the actual video on Instagram. She seemed to be a little bit rough towards Tory Lanez.
It's
aggressive recorded. Towards him. And he was holding it down. All right. So, what you going to say, son?
He was too comfortable lounging with others.
But fuck it. I don't want to stay too much on that shit. That's we going to come back to that, obviously.
I mean, yeah, that's, you know, that's
more information will come out.
Yeah, that's big news, though.
Now, sliding into current event, but speaking also on the topic of shooting, right? So,
buff.
For those who may have seen this clip on Facebook of in a barbershop, there's a dude who just come in, shoot the barber, right? He tell the guy sitting in the chair to kind of scoot to the side, nah, get out the way, I ain't here for you. Homie then in return just pulls a burner out from right underneath the whole motherfucking barbershop gown, and he had shorts on. I'm like, yo, bro, where is this coming from, my nigga? My man turns, hit him with the da-da-da-da-da. Oh, that was about five of them shits. I counted it. I seen the video a couple times.
said the replay.
Real stiff, real quick. What's so crazy, though, is you see the fucking bullets enter through the guy's side, bro.
Yeah.
When you look at the video, I'm like, yo, I seen it a couple times. So I'm like, this shit is crazy. So from hindsight, I'm like, yo, bro, this looked like some wild shit just happening. I'm personally, because I heard dude speaking another language when he shot him. So I'm thinking this is not even in the country, right? Deadass. I'm like, I don't know what's going on. Like, I'm just looking, I'm seeing violence. So I'm like, yo, I don't think this is a part of the whole thing. I mean, part of the country or whatever, because this might be out of the country type shit. But then when I hear dudes say, call the cops, I'm like, all right, now that's definitely.
That's the United States of America.
Yeah. All right, before we go more on jokes, I do kind of want to add the information in for the people who might not know what's going on, right? So, one, this took place in Baltimore, right?
to the guy who shot the barber, he went on a like spree before the barber, and I believe he killed two people before the barber. So that might have been the third person he killed. They didn't say, they don't, I guess they don't have the cause of why he did or went after those particular people. But the person who was in the chair who then in return shot him and killed him was an undercover cop. Not undercover, but off-duty cop. So that's why my nigga looked so stern and he was so calm through the whole situation. Because, boy, I was like, why is he so calm, bro?
Yo.
But not only that, the nigga in the chair. Did you peep the nigga in the chair with the towel on his face? Bro. He did not move. He didn't breathe. I didn't even see the shit go up and down.
But you seen his chest pounding, though.
Yo, bro. You see the
chest pounding?
Bro. Yo, he didn't even move. My man is like, please, Lord, don't let these bullets hit me.
Yo, this is crazy. I'm like, yo, why is he not moving? Yo, he flinched at first, like every like you supposed to hear a gunshot. But after that, he ain't move. He's like, yo, I got this shit over my eyes. I ain't see nothing. I'm not a witness. I'm not here for it. I mean, look, rest in peace to everybody, because that shit's crazy. The other thing that's crazy, too, is, yo, I'm not going to lie to you. When dude came out the chair, like after the dude came in and he shot the barber, bro, I thought that was DJ Khaled. I'm not going to even
another one.
Bro, I just looked at the hairstyle. I just looked at the hairstyle, the skin complexion. I'm like, yo, because I'm like, why does this even have this many views or why is this even circulating? I'm just like, oh, DJ Khaled, bro.
Yeah, you stupid. Yeah, hey, bro, DJ Khaled, Barbara.
Girl, I don't
think niggas like DJ Khaled won't. Yo, he'll call a barber over to his house.
That's what I'm saying. Nah, but when I first seen it, I just thought it was something involved in that. So I'm like, what did he do now? Like, what is this skit? And the crazy thing is, I'm seeing this shit, and I'm like, yo, this shit is so GTA that I'm like, this isn't real. I watched it like maybe three times to be like, wait, are they being for real? Is it a skit? Right. Is it? And then it's like, until I understood, like, first of all, for you to be in that chair getting a haircut. Yes, your barber's the target, but when he let off them, you got to be, boy.
I would hit the ground quick.
Boy. Yo, that was, if dude had terrible aim, it could have been a wrap for him.
But see, and that's what the thing. Well, I ain't gonna lie, the way he did it to make sure he didn't miss. If you kind of it was like over shoulder at him. Like, nigga, I'm gonna get you. But you right.
The crazy shit is that he told dude to move, though. He said, yo, get out of the chair. He said, yo, get out of the way. Get out of the way. And I'm like, okay, what's going to happen next? But you see dude fidgeting with something underneath the smock. Whoop. And he just pulls out the hammer. And I'm like, yo, why are you just strapped like that? Like, we getting haircuts.
On deck.
Like, we just getting haircuts right now. Like, what are we doing? Like, he comes in busting ass. That's why I was just like, yo, this shit has to be a skit. Like, this shit's not real.
Nigga came in straight in for murder.
This guy came, bro. Cold cut. Dude is just... And the crazy thing is... I mean, thankfully, he didn't go in massacre mode because everybody in there was just
that's what I thought vulnerable. Was about to happen until he said, go down my eye. He merciful.
Yeah, like he came here specifically for, well, obviously not if he just came from two other bodies. You know what I'm saying? But maybe those bodies are connected.
That's what I was.
Like maybe the three that he went after, just something, you know.
Something happened.
But that shit looked personal.
It might be some because he don't sound like he's from here. He could have simply like came over for literally that.
Purpose.
Who knows? Like literally somebody like, yo, get these three. You know what I'm saying? You never, because you got to remember, like most of the people who come from other countries, they got a different way of living. Like they homie your ass quick. The way of living is different for them. You're in a third world country. My nigga, you know, bro.
Yeah.
Hey, you know, bro. It's different. Like, it ain't... You talk too crazy to the wrong person. Done. And everybody gonna be like, we didn't see shit because this nigga crazy. And he might kill us. Mm-hmm. So, you know what I mean?
Money on your head.
Might have been one of them type of situations, but that shit looked militant the way my...
I had to watch that like 10, 15 times, bro. I was like... At least. Because I'm thinking it's a skit. I said, that doesn't make sense. Like, he's getting a haircut. Dude comes in, busts the barber... Tells you to move out of the way. Like, he's like, I'm not here for you. Get out of here. I think he even told him get to the ground or something. But then he turned. First of all, if you come in there with a gun, bro, you got to secure everybody. Like, if you've ever seen anything with a gun, like, you make sure everyone's accounted for. Like, but you could tell he was just so focused on who That's he it. Came for. He wasn't thinking, like, yo, they in the barbershop strapped. Who's going to think that? Like, you're the person in the chair that has nothing to do with the barber. They have no relationship.
Oh, so you think.
So you think, but I'm if he's just go, Because, bro, like, you tell the dude, you tell the move out of the way.
Is the dude that just ended you. That shit is kind of crazy, though.
5 seconds even though
he,
later.
He was the bad guy.
No. Absolutely,
but
bro.
It is still crazy.
It's crazy. It's like, yo, get down. It's that whole situation is crazy. And yes, it's not a skit. I just had to watch because it was just that so unbelievable, wild. Bro. I was just like, yo, what the fuck is all of this?
My man hit that nigga with the...
No flinching. Quick five.
That shit was wild.
Ben secured the door like he was like...
Yo, I don't know, bro. I don't know. I don't know if he was good. He might have kind of snapped after a while. Fuck it. I'm going to just do y'all all in.
That's
what I think, at least.
Because he just committed. And now, everyone's saying he's an undercover cop, right? Or some shit like that. But look, he witnessed murder. He had to do what he had to do.
He had to do what he had to do. That's his job.
That's his undercover job. Undercover or not. Now, if he don't do that, job. And then guess what? Dude changed his mind and feel like, oh, no witnesses. Because dude came in with no mask.
He didn't.
You understand what I'm saying? It would have been a little different if he came with the face covered, did what he did, then tell Duke move out of the way, because now it's like, it's not really, y'all not a witness to this. But he came in with nothing, just face and a hat on. It's like, yo. So I'm like, what would he have done after the fact? He probably would have realized, like, damn, there's witnesses.
Damn, and a fucking camera, nigga. Staring right at your bozo ass. I don't think they'd be camera. Son, when I was in that little life, when I went through the court system, I was in jail, bro, it was a lot of dudes. Like, they niggas don't speak no English, right? But they bout that motherfucking life at a level that you have never seen before. Like, they, nigga, I don't care. I'm going to go. Nigga, they just going to send me back to my country. But I came over here to make sure that motherfucker don't ever speak about my man's back home.
Yeah.
Obviously, he ain't saying this shit in English. Somebody is telling us what he's saying, but that nigga like, nah, I don't give a fuck. I'm going to just get deported.
Yeah.
You gonna stay here for 20 years, not me. I'm going to fuck back wherever the fuck I'm at, and they're gonna get me out.
Yeah.
So I'm good. Nigga.
Good luck.
Different life. It's just a different lifestyle. Nigga came here to murder two people and get deported back there, and they're gonna get him out. So he, you know what I mean? It's like some fucking spy. Motherfuckers, fucking cartel nigga sends a nigga over there, right?
Yeah.
We know he gonna get pinched. So what? They're gonna deport his ass right back, and we gonna get him out.
Get him out. Easy.
That shit's crazy though, bro.
Where y'all think the movies get it from?
Shit really be happening like that, dogs.
Inspired by a true
story. Yo, you is stupid. He's inspired by a true story. Hey, we ain't got no more to speak about, but I do kind of want to get a little nerdy. What about the Spider-Man? I didn't see the Spider-Man, but I don't really care for spoilers and shit.
Don't do that. What do you mean you don't care for spoilers? Don't do that.
No, I don't care because I'm going to see it. I'm so invested in this shit. I'm already so much movies deep. I gotta. So, if I don't, my life wouldn't make sense.
I'll ask you this. Have you seen every Spider-Man movie prior to this one here? Every single one of
every
them?
Every one of them.
When I say every Spider-Man movie, I mean
no, ever, I mean every Spider-Man movie. All three of them motherfuckers. All
right.
I didn't like Toby, but I took care. I made sure to watch it because I was the only Spider-Man at the moment.
So I had to go back and watch him.
I ain't like Toby. No, I watched it though. When it dropped, when it came out, his enemies was fire. They did a fantastic job with his enemies. I disliked him as the Spider-Man.
Yeah,
he seemed too nerdy. Seemed too stiff. Then when he became Venom, what the fuck are you doing? Yeah, bro, you're dancing down the street. Pack that shit up. What the fuck is this guy doing, bro?
With the hairstyle?
He's irritating
with
me, bro.
The eyeliner?
Yeah, bro.
It's killing me.
Negatives. Fucking negative, son.
They said Spider-Man 3 should have never did it like that. Because they tried to force so much. First of all, you don't try to slam Venom and Sandman in one movie. Those are just two separate entities. Like if you're gonna throw in Venom, you gotta throw like in another petty villain. Not somebody.
Because
like,
Venom is gonna smoke this is mine, nigga. Yeah. That was always I'm fucking killing him, bro. You mean I'm a ruin this nigga's whole. I hate him. I'ma eat this nigga and take his shit. That's how it was. It wasn't no we gonna partner where? Fuck you, nigga. This is all me. Venom was always Carnage was way worse, obviously, but because he was feeding off of the energy of his father, which is Venom. But nonetheless, it's like, dude, nah, you can't do this, but yo, this is the funny part. Bro, I was talking, I forgot who I was talking to earlier today. I'm like, yo, have you ever realized this nigga, like, Eddie Brock is, like, he is the OG of hate. Like, I never in my life seen a motherfucker go to a church and pray that God kills a nigga.
Where do you see...
in the movie. You remember? Yes, it was the same one with Venom.
With the first Venom?
Yeah, yeah, the first Venom and with Toby, nigga. With the Toby Spider-Man.
Oh!
This nigga, yeah, the nigga was in church. This
Because he seen he got the girl, he got everything. Yeah, he was
this tight. Nigga prayed.
Yeah, he hated
for
yeah.
this nigga to die. Yeah. And then that's when he got the Venom, because the Venom was in a fucking whatchamacallit.
Yeah, because Duke was up there getting.
Bro, I was fucking dying. I forgot about that situation.
I'm like, he really is OG.
Hate. Yeah. I never seen no hate shit like the nigga prayed to God for you to die. Yeah,
that's OD. I forgot about when you said that. I said when he did that. Because I'm thinking about new Venom. But yeah, even the Brock that they casted then, trash. I ain't gonna, because they wasn't, Brock wasn't small like that. If you look at comics and all of that, Brock was stocky. Some so Brock like that there. never really fit for me anyway.
That shit was funny.
It's still a classic, because to be honest, let me not skip over Blade like that. Blade opened doors.
Straight up.
But Spider-Man was like the next
kid friendly, also action. It's like it grabs every fucking body. Even a grandmother can watch that and be like, this is not bad. I can
No, it's classic. My man violated Toby though. But yeah, you're right. Out of all three of them, Toby is like the
I hate Toby shit. I even like the second nigga. I like his Spider-Man, and he's supposed to be supposedly, what movie is he supposed to be playing the Spider-Man in? Did they say not the next Venom? What was the fucking movie? It's somebody else's movie, he's going to play the Spider-Man in that movie. And I'm like, I'm glad they're bringing him back, because he was a good Spider-Man to me. People didn't like him, but I don't know why. I think he was better than Toby. I hate Toby Spider-Man. Fucking weirdo-ass looking nigga.
I think if they would have started with him, it would have been a little bit much better. It's because,
I think so too.
Bro, the reason, listen, Marvel, you guys are the OGs of the comic book movie world. It is what it is. DC, I had hope for y'all, but y'all have a lot of work to do. But
oh, anyway, no. DC are the shows. Have you really been seeing
the show? No, of course, yeah. No, the shows are always elite. The animes, wow, the animes, the like the animated shit, they killing Marvel.
They be violent. No way.
Whoever y'all have doing your animated shit, just take them niggas and put them in the cinematic universe. Am I bugging or something, bro?
No, well, see, certain people, they're work. Right, let's say this is.
Fuck that.
What's his name? Zack Snyder. Okay. Now, everybody's like, you need to be the guy for DC. Fuck everything else. Yeah. You should shoot everything DC from this point on. He's like, well, this is going to be my last movie. We're like, wait, what are you talking about, buddy? Yeah. You see what we need you for, and you're going to go somewhere else? The fuck is wrong with you? I do believe he's in the TV shows. That's why I think he's... Bro, them TV shows are fire, bro.
Yeah.
Titans, that shit. Boy, if you haven't seen Titans, listen. I said DC. Spider. I'm bugging. I'm glad. You know, let me not let us... Bro, the way this nigga, Robin, goes... Bro, no.
I don't like who they casted as Bruce Wayne, though.
The shit. No. This ain't no pat you in the back. You just going to slide to the ground and be knocked out. Blood. I'm murdering niggas. I'm beating the brakes off these... Yo, when he hit in that show, nigga, I'll be like, ooh, shit. That shit is worse than Daredevil, nigga. Yeah. The show. Remember the Daredevil show? Yeah. That shit was fire on Netflix. This nigga fighting scenes, the greatest fucking fight scenes I've ever seen on Netflix.
I can't.
Fuck that.
You never seen the Daredevil neither?
That's what I'm talking about. Daredevil, okay. I'm talking about specifically, I'm saying it's better than the Daredevil.
You gotta hurry up and go see Spider-Man, bro. Because now it's a whole... Damn, I can't even...
No, it's tying.
I can't even tell him. I can't even.
Bro, I'm cool.
No, nigga.
I'm cool. I'm gonna see the movie.
He's throwing everything in the. It's go now.
No, I'm
get out. It's going down. The theater's like 10 minutes away, bro.
I'm gonna see this shit. It's just my whole problem is I don't care for theaters anymore, bro. Everything I like my comfortability. I got my Doobie. I got my Munchies.
Yeah, they spoiled us. I
ain't gonna lie. Once they say cannabis theater, my nigga, I will be at every single movie that drops. I cannot. I enjoy my smoke while I'm watching the movie. This shit is the greatest thing for me, because it's like, and my house turns to IMAX when I'm high.
Yeah.
Lights dim. Bow. Let's get this shit going. Volume nice and high. I'm like, yo, see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I don't want to fuck people vibe. If I'm in a movie theater stomping and I'm wilding in my house, nigga. I'm wild. I'm like a little fucking kid with it.
You're going to have to get that shit a pass. And if you go see it, go see it in the 4RDX. The shit where your chairs is.
Oh, this nigga want me to spend $35. It might be worth it,
though. Oh, my God, bro. Listen to me, man. Spider-Man, bro, is... And I'm pretty sure they're, like, one of the top grossing films of all time now.
No. It is.
Bro, that movie, the way that they... Obviously, everyone knows all three Spider-Mans are in it. Like, that's not something you can get away from now.
They're, like, in it for beyond 20 minutes.
Bro, go, God damn, I can't even, tell him anything.
No, just the minutes. Beyond 20.
No, I'm not telling you nothing, bro.
Hey, this nigga's not, he's not trying to. Bro, I'm trying to get a little something.
Spider-Man gave you every emotion, bro. You went, for the ones that went in to go, like, oh shit, that's dope. You went in there.
He was crying.
Bro.
It made you closely almost drop tears?
Bro. I wasn't gonna cry, but
no, I know the situation. I know a lot more than you think I know.
Nah.
That's what I'm trying to tell you.
That's not why. No.
Okay, got you. So it's more.
It's damn. You have to see all Spider-Mans. You have every single one of them.
Yo, they wild out.
You don't miss a moment in there. That's all I can say, bro. The movie, I gotta go see it again. This is a must. When this is available digital, it's not because Sony doesn't really have a platform. It's not like you can't go to Marvel and get the old Spider-Mans. You could get the current shit.
You can't, like, only thing that you can get Disney. Disney's where you go to app, you will see every motherfucking Marvel that popped up within the last couple years. Everything. All of the motherfucking events.
But do
all
you have the Spider-Mans though? They don't
have the Spider-Man.
Because they have it. Sony's like, don't push it.
Not the Amazing Spider-Man and not the other three Tobys.
No, they're not going to have them. But I thought they would have the latest Spider-Man.
Let me see. Do they? I'm going to double check. I do not. I'm going to double check. I ain't going to say whether they do it or not.
I lost this earlier. Marvel, A1 in the comic, in the cinematic universe, A1. The draft picks, the actors that they pick, Tom Holland is because he's really a fucking kid. They really, Marvel said, fuck that. We gonna do it the way, not a kid, but.
I love his energy. He's a good actor. Yeah, his energy.
You see the shit, you like, yes, this is comic book. This is Spider-Man. This is him. He's young. He's doing, bro. And I like that they didn't start him off with his own single movie. Like Marvel didn't just say, hey, Spider-Man movie. They had to like, okay, you got to bring him in from somewhere. They put him in that the Civil War, and when he came out, that was more than enough for me to see. I seen that shit. I was like, oh, they killed Spider-Man. And then once he came out with his own, bro, this Spider-Man movie is probably one of the best. Like,
I got sights, so I probably might watch that tonight. Don't even worry about it, bro. I got sights. I'm gonna watch that tonight, and then I'm gonna probably watch it again when it comes out. And I'm probably gonna watch it again. Yo, I watch Marvel movies so much. It's like that's why for me, it's like it ain't a big deal for me the first time see it. It's like I'm going to run this shit to the ground, bro.
Yeah.
The last two that came out, I watched these shits are 3 hours, bro.
Yeah.
I watched them and like piece it and then watch it again 3 days later. Like, no, I want the full thing. I didn't like how I stopped, and then watched the full thing straight through, my nigga. So it's like. Yeah. I was meaning to, but just certain shit happened, and I was meaning to fucking see it.
The pod like this.
I wanted to take Noah, and he's close. He's there, bro. Like now he'll be like, whoa! I'm like, oh, I want so fucking bad. I want that experience with him so bad. So I'm like,
don't take him to the RDX. He might flip out. He get thrown into the water.
I just want to make sure because this moment, now he'd be like, whoa! Look at that, the guy just he's there now. Yeah, so I'm like, whoa.
Yeah, you understand?
He really gonna be like, I want him to.
He's not gonna even remember the gem you putting on to him right now. Spider-Man is amazing, bro. You just reminded me. I gotta go see that shit again.
I'm gonna see that shit.
What else is current? I mean, that's pretty much it for
right
now.
That's what we got for y'all, man. We're gonna have more precise. We're gonna give y'all some more financial talk, a whole lot of stuff. But we just wanted to come back and let y'all know that we here, right? And we back at this.
Yeah, we back. Look, a bunch of random but current topics. There's a lot of shit going on right now. We happy to be back. Yes, we'll get better and better. We'll get back to where we were, a little out of shape.
Yo, and we're going to come out. We come with merch. That's what's about to happen, too. All right, merch is coming. We ain't going to tell you what it is, but merch is coming.
What else we got? That's pretty much it. No shout-outs to nobody. Happy New Year's. Damn, we haven't seen y'all.
Happy fucking New
Year's. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Thanksgiving,
all that good shit. Did we miss Halloween too?
Martin Luther King Day.
Happy belated Martin Luther King
Day. You missed a lot of that, man. So
and a lot of fucking RIPs, man. It's so much.
Sidney
Poitier, man. Straight up, RIP Sidney Poitier. Man, that was crazy. Betty White. She passed away too.
Yeah, Betty White came out of nowhere.
She's a part of our culture.
She came out of nowhere.
She always showed love to us. You know what I'm saying? Always.
That shit was like a wow.
Always. Ooh, man, it's a lot of fucking people, man. If I can get his last name, that's my dude, man. I don't want to fucking butcher it. I ain't going to butcher it.
But there's a lot of people passing away, unfortunately.
R.I.P. R.I.P.
Yeah, there's a lot of R.I.P.s out there. But we'll catch y'all next episode. I actually got to fucking run to work to go wrap up.
You some motherfuckers.
Gang. Wavy. Honey. Gang in the spot. Wavy. Say you my nigga, then say that. Don't try to switch sides, nigga, I don't play that. Couple bands on your head, homie, slide to the crib where you stay at. Me and gang go way back. Big bag, I'ma make that. If you take a loss and I lose, nigga, just know gang gon' shake. You my nigga didn't say that. Say you my nigga didn't say that. Say you my nigga. Say you my nigga. Say you my nigga didn't say that. Say you my nigga didn't say that. Say you my nigga. Say you my nigga. I got a torch, you getting scorched. How about the van, hit up his door. I need a land, me and my man, cause I got a plan that we gonna ball. Nigga, I'm next, I need a check. I need my kids, all of the guests. I want the money, feed all the fam, cause any other shit is keeping me stressed. Love all my niggas, they coming first. Free all my niggas, that's jacking the set. I got the drip, she getting wet. A nigga like me, he gonna do it the best. She on high, never settle for less. If I slide, then I'm making a mess. Bro with me, got a tech in the vest. Run him up, put a dot in his neck. Nigga, my nigga didn't say that. Don't try to switch sides, nigga, I don't play that. Couple bands on your head, homie, slide to the crib where you stay at. Me and gang go way back. Big bag, I'ma make that. If you take a loss and I lose, nigga, just know gang gon' shake. Say you my nigga didn't say that. Say you my nigga didn't say that. Say you my nigga, say you my nigga. Say you my nigga didn't say that. Say you my nigga didn't say that. Say you my nigga, say you my nigga.
Who's a bitch? Nigga, I'm Crip. You try to front that nigga is lit. Run up a bag, first to the fifth. Smoking a Dez, hold out the zip. Say my nigga, then say that. If you get the bag, make that. Bitch niggas, I hate that. They copy the swag and I made that. Whoosh it, whoosh it. They like the way that we do shit. She slide up, then I shoot shit. Bitch mouth, too ruthless. 120 in the coupe, bitch. Same gang, no new shit. Get straight, and you knew this. Rubber bands full of blues, bitch.
Say you my nigga, then say that. Don't try to switch sides, nigga, I don't play that. Couple bands on your head, homie, slide to the crib where you stay at. Me and gang go way back. Big bag, I'ma make that. If you take a loss and I lose, nigga, just know gang gon' shake. You my nigga didn't say that. Say you my nigga didn't say that. Say you my nigga, say you my nigga. Say you my nigga didn't say that. Say you my nigga didn't say that. Say you my nigga, say you my nigga. I come from the Jets, I need to be high to hop on a plane. I'm not gonna play, I'ma get to the top, fuck all the games. They call us a chill, but they wanna fuck, they loving the game. I'm bowling like Rose, RP bro, throw them all in the chain. My shooter rolling with a 40 on them, and if he see a op, boom them. Hop in the V, zooming. We was never outside, cool it. Bitches be thoughts, choosing. Yeah, I ride for the gang, stupid. I leave a op, ruthless. Yeah, I leave a op, ruthless. Say you my nigga, then say that. Don't try to switch sides, nigga, I don't play that. Couple bands on your head, homie, slide to the crib where you stay at. Me and gang go way back. Big bag, I'ma make that. If you take a loss and I lose, nigga, just know gang gon' shake. Say you my nigga, then say that. Say you my nigga, then say that. Say you my nigga, say you my nigga. Say you my nigga, then say that. Say you my nigga, then say that. Say you my nigga, say you my nigga.